To be able to transform this render to this other one, we're going to see how we can use ChatGPT and OpenAI's Sora platform, which will allow us a bit more flexibility in our work. So, we can use, if you have the free version of ChatGPT, simply the create function, the create images function we have here, and we add the images we want and some type of text prompt. In this case, I have added this description, transform this render to an ID scene, through the lights of the house, and but keep the rest of the design exactly the same. If you have the free version of ChatGPT, well, you will have, I think it's 3 daily image generations, images like this, which will take approximately 1 minute to create. It will take this transformation, and it will get this image and transform it into this. Look at the result, well, it's not exactly the best, but it's quite decent. We can here again iterate these images to go correcting more details from a new prompt that we keep introducing. However, if you, and I recommend that at least once you try the Sora platform, and Sora, if you have the ChatGPT Plus version that costs $20 per month, you can press it here on Sora. And now this platform will allow us to generate images and videos using this OpenAI artificial intelligence, but in an unlimited way, yes. Just as you heard it, unlimited. For me, that's what's great about the Sora platform, that we can create as many images and videos as we want during the month that we have the subscription available. In this case, well, I've already created 2 images, so we can analyze them, and the system is very, very similar. You upload your image here, choose if you want to make a video or if you want an image. Since we're making an image, we're going to stay here. And here you upload the source image that you want to attach to use for the generation. Choose a aspect ratio for your image depending on the type of content you're creating. Unfortunately, at the moment, we don't have 16:9 to use yet. But well, these are still some of the standards that are used most, especially in social media. We can also add more variations. For example, here we can create 2 images to be generated in the same generation, which will make the iteration process a bit simpler and faster by having more options when generating our images. And finally, we could add some of these styles that OpenAI already offers us by default. However, for what we are doing, I just suggest you to leave it unknown. So let's analyze what I did. What I did here, we're going to review this. I uploaded my original images and set a text prompt for it, which was to maintain the original design, but to transform it into an ideal scene and turn on some lights, an image in 3:2 aspect ratio, proportion, and for it to be 2 variations. When I restarted the generation, this image was created, and this other one over here. If you notice, well, it already has quite an interesting level. It has added the lights here with their respective glow, some recessed light here. It has turned on these lights. It added artificial lighting here. Look how inside the house it looks quite good. Same as this one. I also like it quite a bit. Look how the lights have turned on in this area. It has added some recessed lights here, some lights here too, the ones we have here. But the important thing is that once we have our images, we can do a remix. This remix will allow us to give it a new description to modify the image depending on what we want. However, here we have an additional tool, which is the brush that we have. I could, for example, select this and all over here paint it to select some area of our image that we want to change in this new edition. No longer just from text, but also using this visual tool. We could, for example, add here a few bushes. And we're going to see in a new generation that we are going to remix this image. We're going to modify it with 2 new variations. Let's see the result it generates for us. And when you do a remix, it sends it to the queue. Here you will see the queue of elements that are being rendered. Depending on the type of plan you have paid for, the Plus or the Pro plan, which is much more expensive, but will have many more elements that you can render simultaneously. And they can even, if you have the higher value subscription, have up to 4 images rendered in the same batch. For now, we're going to wait it for to finish, and we have already our result here. Let's click it here to see it, And look now how we have our new generation with these bushes we have in this area. And this way you can go making different variations. It seems that it wasn't this one. Let's see where it ended up. Here it is. We have this one here and we have this other variation here. Well, you could go making all the adjustments you want with this remix function, all the changes, as I mentioned. Well, since this is the paid version of ChatGPT Plus, you'll have unlimited generation, which is quite useful to be able to make all these type of variations. And we can even generate videos from these images that we have created. We're going to see in the next video how to do this. And likewise, if you want to learn how to generate this type of time lapses, like the one you're seeing on the screen, using these two images, I invite you to watch the next video.